What's up, everybody? Checking in with another cleat review today. We have probably something that's much anticipated that we haven't done in a while. We got some new boots. I know we did the new Ronaldo Vapors, but we have for you today the new F50 AdiZeros, the synthetic model, going back to the all-synthetic model. I got them in a size 9 in the new colorway, the vivid yellow, black, and green Zest. Got to try these on, play with them a little bit, so kind of show you my take. Extra pair of inserts, decently standard with F50s. They give you that kind of suede finish insert, so that's, you do get a little bit extra with these, whereas the Adidas boots usually wouldn't give you any extra bags or anything like that, like Nike does. But all right, down to the boots themselves. Obviously, right off the bat, very cool looking shoe. I'm a big black and yellow fan, so I really like the color of these guys. They got a little green trim right here. First thing you're going to notice with these guys is the upper is almost completely different than what you're used to. Adidas moved away from the synthetic, or the all synthetic F50s, and they've moved back into that, which is, I think, for the better, honestly, to have both options, both the leather and synthetic. These guys have the full sprint skin upper. They have the what they call the sprint web technology, which is kind of a finish on the upper. It's a much different finish than what you guys are probably used to. It's kind of a rigid, you can kind of see it with the camera. It's really hard to see unless you're actually just feeling the boots, but very gritty upper. I know I probably use that term a lot, but these guys are very ridgy and have that nice what they call the sprint web, like a 3D finish on the upper of the boot. It's that single layer synthetic. Very, very lightweight, both on the foot and in the hand. It actually feels lighter on the foot than it does in the hand. These guys are 5.8 ounces. So extremely, extremely light shoe. Pretty wide in the toe box as well. I noticed that I was able to fit pretty well in these, even with a wider foot. It wasn't stretching too much on the sides. It was a pretty decent fit, pretty comfortable fit, and just so light on your feet, you almost feel like you're wearing nothing. These are even lighter, probably the lightest I remember trying on, but extremely light. Other than that, for the upper, you have the sprint frame, which is pretty standard with all the Adidas boots. Goes throughout, kind of just gives you that heel support. As far as the bottom stud layout, it's a new stud configuration. It's a little different in a sense where these up here are kind of almost like tilted back a little bit. As you can see, they kind of kick back a little bit right there. They're not too different than the kind of the standard triangular studs. They have little indentations in them. You got the stability stud right in here, MiCoach cavity, as most Adidas upper echelon boots have, but pretty similar stud configuration, but a little bit different. As you can see, it kind of breaks almost at a diagonal in there, and it's just supposed to give you a little bit better balance. Obviously got the two bigger ones right here and in the back for the balance, but pretty similar stud configuration. Like I said, a little bit different in the front, but I didn't feel any uneven stud pressure or any type of stud pressure at all. These were actually really, really comfortable, and I'm not a huge F50 guy. I mean, I don't have anything against them, but they're not my boot of choice, and I really enjoyed these. I thought they were pretty good. As far as the insole, pretty standard perforated sock liner, very thin, lightweight, nothing really to write home about, nothing too intense there. You do get the extra inserts right here, but just overall a very solid shoe. I feel like Adidas going back to the synthetic is definitely the right move to give kind of the option of having either the synthetic or leather rather than kind of just grouping them together like they have been doing with all the recent F50s. But definitely probably one of the lightest shoes I've ever felt on the foot, especially, and you feel like you just have a really, really good touch on the ball. It's a really, really thin synthetic. It's as thin as I remember it being for any boot I've ever tried on. Just extremely, extremely comfortable. I really don't have a ton of negative feedback on these. I feel like Adidas really did these right. And I enjoyed the fact that they've kind of taken the time and they're really going with both the leather and synthetic, because I feel like that worked better than kind of just having the leather front and having that whole hybrid type shoe. But definitely did it right with these guys. I am extremely happy with these. I would actually go with these. And like I said, I'm not an F50 guy. So hope you guys enjoyed the review. It's pretty much what I got for the functionality of the shoe. I that's pretty much all I got. So keep sending your comments, feedback, questions, reviews you guys would want to see. Let me know kind of what you guys think and what you want to see, and I'll try to kind of do some requests and stuff coming up. And again, keep sending in your goal store free kick videos. We're going to be, I know I've been saying this for a while, we're going to be narrowing down our finalists in the next few weeks. So please keep sending the videos to us so we can get some good free kick videos and get some of our subscribers on the channel and show their stuff kind of thing. So that's pretty much all I got. Hope you guys are well. I will talk to you soon. We're going to be having some more reviews coming out with new boots. We just got a bunch of new ones from Adidas, so I'll have some more to share with you soon. But until then, I hope you guys are well, and I'll talk to you soon. Take care.